In this video, I will show you how to efficiently use a key figure of merit during the design phase of the circuit, the error vector magnitude, also known as EVM. Indeed, using modulated signals criteria like EVM has recently become an essential need for every high-frequency design to respect the wireless standards. Two main hurdles faced were that computing the EVM was not always easy, and the simulation runtime could be prohibitive in some cases. The net result was at best, only a couple of numerologies were tested during the verification phase, and sometimes designs were only relying on short channel bandwidth approximations like IP3. That impact on the design was never minimal, either overdesign or, more painfully, failures to comply with standards and respins. Now, two features developed by Keysight, available on Keysight PNX and simulation tools such as ADS or Golden Gate, can help designers to quickly assess the error vector magnitude during the design phase, and with a runtime that can be divided by at least 10x. The Distortion EVM algorithm that will compute the EVM without the need to demodulate the signal. The compact test signals to speed up simulations with minimal impact on the EVM accuracy. With these two features, one can now overcome the two main hurdles that were highlighted to use EVM during the design phase. Let's start with the Distortion EVM. Distortion EVM is a way to estimate the error vector magnitude out of nonlinear simulations with envelope, but without the need of an external system simulator. In traditional approaches, EVM is computed in time domain. That's the case for spectrum analyzers and our links with system view. That's pretty accurate, but the prerequisite is that the output signal must be demodulated before the time domain EVM processing. That implies to know the full numerology of the input source to get a proper demodulation and a data flow engine to produce the results. Distortion EVM solves the EVM in a different way, using a frequency approach. Indeed, from Parseval's theorem, one can state the EVM computed in time is equivalent to the one computed in the frequency domain. The first aspect is to separate the nonlinear behavior of the output signal spectrum into the sum of two components. The linear distortion part that you can see as a function of the small signal behavior and the compression. This is what we are used to being extracted through swept one tone. Secondly, the nonlinear distortion part that is noise shape and is mainly a function of ACPR, noise power ratio, and error vector magnitude. Once it's separated, the EVM can be computed through the following equation, gathering the inbound information of the nonlinear distortion. And this works on any type of signals, multiplexed or non-multiplexed, and without the need of demodulating the signal. How to use this inside ADS? Let's take an example of a Keysight power amplifier used in some of our instruments. Using Distortion EVM is super simple. In this example, we load the amplifier with a 100 MHz bandwidth 5G NR source operating at 4.5 GHz. The envelope setup is classic, setting up the time stop according to the resolution we want and the time step to the expected frequency span. We can run the simulation as usual, nothing different from what was done before for an ACPR simulation. But contrarily to the classical time domain EVMs, you can even use controllers like optimization, design on experiment, or Monte Carlo to see the spread of the EVM over different conditions. The EVM becomes a design figure of merit as easily as gain or ACPR and avoids using approximations like IP3. Once the simulation is done, the distortion EVM will be computed through an equation in the data display. It will allow you to display the EVM, but also the spectrum of the two parts of the EVM decomposition. You can even display the EVM through time windows. That is really practical when the amplifier is switched on and off, as the latest Wi-Fi standards like Wi-Fi 6 do recommend preserving the power consumption or, if on battery, the battery life. What about the accuracy? This methodology has been validated on our instruments, comparing the time domain techniques of the VSA with the frequency domain techniques of the PNAX. The curves represent the EVM over power and frequency sweeps with two different modulation schemes fed into a 28 GHz power amplifier. The curves do match well when the power amplifier is in nonlinear condition, and Distortion EVM is even showing less residuals on lower input powers. On the simulation side, Distortion EVM has of course been checked versus the Dataflow EVM that SystemView can compute through virtual test benches. You can find here the comparison of a swept input power EVM for a 5 GHz power amplifier. These results do correlate extremely well, as you can see. Okay, but will that speed up my simulations? Indeed, it also gives a speed advantage, as there is no need to communicate with an external data flow engine. But that's a marginal gain. The main interest of the Distortion EVM is to simplify the design workflow by bringing the EVM into the design phase rather than being the potential final figure of merit to check if time permits. But let's see now how to speed up the simulation part. The second feature is named Compact Test Signals. Now that Distortion EVM can compute the EVM easily, the main intent is to be able to accelerate simulations with compact test signals. The underlying idea is to find a shorter subset of the original waveform that has very close frequency characteristics and then make the final simulation with this shorter waveform. On the screen, you can see two scenarios stemming from a 1 millisecond waveform representing a 5G NR signal with 100 MHz bandwidth. On the left, we use a 10 microseconds window for the compact test signals. That means that we are trying to find a subset of the original waveform with a length of 10 microseconds that best represents the original waveform. Looking at, for example, the CCDF, it is decent, but not really great for the high powers. On the right now, a 100 microseconds window is used, and you can easily see that the fit is much better. And then, using this 100 microseconds compact version of the 5G NR original waveform will produce the same results as if we were using the original one. But as the simulation will run with 100 microseconds instead of the original 1 millisecond, the runtime will be divided by 10, which is already a very good improvement. It is straightforward to use the compact test signals. There's one checkbox to activate and one field to choose the window length. There's obviously a trade-off between speed and accuracy, but you will find in the simulation log file the CCDF error between the original and the compact waveforms as a guidance. On the result side, no big change if you're using a compact waveform or not. The main difference is that it will run way faster than the traditional approach. As a summary, the combination of compact test signals and Distortion EVM is meant to be simple, quick, and accurate. Simple, as it seamlessly brings for both ADS and Golden Gate EVM inside the design phase and obsoletes the usage of IP3 that is no longer a valid assumption for the large channels. Quick, as you can now obtain the results 10 to more than 100 times faster than before. Accurate, as we cannot compromise with accuracy. This has been checked both on the measurement and simulation sides to ensure a good correlation between time and frequency domain EVMs. And with a lower runtime, you can also increase your test coverage. Thanks for watching.